The horse's center of gravity is located one hand behind the elbow, which is here, okay? So if you put a rider on top of this horse or a skeleton and you want it to balance properly over the horse's center of gravity, you don't want to put the rider's knee behind this point. What you would like is that the seat bones are slightly behind this point and that the knee is just over it or slightly in front of it, because in that way, the rider is more centered. The rider can center his weight more easily over the horse's center of gravity. Let's also not forget the horse has a center of motion. He has a center of gravity here. He has a center of motion which is located here. The center of motion is in the loin area of the horse. So when my seat bones are here, my thigh stretches to here. I sit very comfortably in the saddle. If I want to get close to this silly line that everyone's talking about, I bend my knee and put my heel back here. However, I don't always ride that way. If you look at classical Greek and Roman sculpture, you will see that those really muscular, good-looking guys sitting on the horses have their knee in this position and their lower leg just drops straight down. That people in dressage, unfortunately, call that a chair seat, but it is the natural seat of a well-balanced horseman, okay? So when we bend our knee and put our lower leg back here, we should be doing that in order to give a certain aid, in order to ask the hind legs to do something different. It should not be position A, if you will, on the horse. That is an active leg that is requesting something. So position A, a neutral seat, the leg just drops straight down. Now, I would point out that if your saddle has a big knee roll that's in the wrong place, and your knee is here, then located here on the saddle, if your knee gets pushed back to here, your lower leg, if you bend it slightly, will be here, and you will be riding in a what I would call a permanent canter position with your lower leg. This is not where you ask the horse, sorry honey, this is not where you ask the horse to bend. You ask the horse to bend here. So if your saddle has a huge knee roll right there, there's no way you're going to get the tip of your spur on this part of your horse. If you watch my belt buckle, you will see how much motion is in a decent sitting trot. There's a lot of up and down motion. This part of me moves a lot. The thighs are very relaxed. They are not gripping the horse. I am not gripping with my knees. My whole leg is draped, and the weight of my leg, or the weight of my toe, is received in the stirrup. I am not forcing my heels down. My knee is entirely flexible. I'll show you here. I can take it off the horse. I can lift it up a little bit. If you can't lift your knee at all because the knee roll blocks you, then you probably can't sit very deep on your horse. You want to put all of your weight on your seat bones. So clamping the knees in will lighten your weight. Relaxing the knee will deepen your weight, will make your weight heavier on the horse.